What's poppin', Panthers? It's Alize.
And it's your girl, Gabby.
Wow, it's been a while. I'm so glad it's a new year.
Tell me about it. 2020 was a year to remember.
You could say that again. Here are some 2020 fun facts.
What's up, Panthers? It's been a whole year since I've last talked to y'all.
Get him out of here. That's not even funny. Get him out of here, bro.
Delete this video.
All right. I get it.
Delete the whole video.
Anyway, 2020 was a crazy year. But with the news about the elections and masks and COVID, there's bound to be a couple fun facts that you didn't hear about. And I'm here to bring them to you. Speaking of the idea that the world was being doomed forever that was pushed throughout 2020, remember the murder hornets? Those hornets that popped up in Washington and then pretty much never hit the news headlines again? Well, it turns out that even though it is very much possible that they can kill a human, they were actually named murder hornets because they decapitate honeybees and feed their bodies to their kids. That's a bad thing because, you know what? Go watch the bee movie if you want to know what the world would be like without honey. Another one of the weird things that happened in 2020 was a rat being given a prestigious gold medal. The rat was being recognized because it helped people in Cambodia sniff out some unexploded landmines. That's just proof that not all heroes wear capes. Did y'all know that penguin poop can produce laughing gas? Some researchers in Denmark and China were studying the effects of king penguins on the environment, and after a couple hours, they started to feel loopy. The penguin poop that was breaking down in the area releases nitrous oxide, which is the same stuff that's sometimes used by dentists to help patients feel comfortable during certain procedures. One of the people there said that after a couple hours of being outside, one goes crazy. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed those fun facts and honestly can't wait to see what 2021 brings us. See y'all later.
Thanks, AJ. There were some pretty cool things that happened in 2020.
I know, right? Hey guys, course elections are coming up. And if you're fun, creative, and you like editing videos, you should think about AV production. Take a look.
In this course, students will learn the basics of production. So there are three phases to production: pre-production, production, and post-production. So students will learn how to gather information for a production. They'll actually learn physically how the production works, and then they'll learn the third step, which is post-production, and that is editing the footage that they got in production. A lot of times people will see the end result, right? They'll see what ends up on the screen, whether it's the big screen, the small screen, or your computer screen. But they don't think about the work that goes into the production side of it. How do we get to that end point? And it's a lot. A lot of work goes into it. A lot of hands are involved. Just think about it. When you watch a movie and you see the end credits, there's a long list of names that go into that production. And so you can't do this by yourself. You're going to need to learn how to work with people, and people are going to need to learn how to work with you. I want students to take away an experience that will allow them to grow both personally and professionally. One of the things that I pride myself in is really instilling in students that this is not just a classroom. It's really an aspect of your life that will propel you in so many different areas. So even if you don't aspire to be this big time television or film producer, there's things in this class that you can learn that'll help you in any industry that you choose to go into. I know there's some students and people that say, oh, I'm not creative, but everybody has a creative side. And in this class, it's a good element of storytelling. And we all have a story to tell. We all come from various backgrounds. We have various experiences. And this class is like an outlet that allows students to channel everything that they've gone through or are going through production. You know, the one thing that I'm looking for in students is someone who is willing to learn. And you don't have to come in with prior knowledge. But what I am looking for you to come in with is a desire to learn. I'm Derek Stevenson, and I teach AV production.
That class looks really fun. Mr. Stevenson does a fantastic job on bringing kids together as a class.
Speaking of bringing things together, Martin Luther King Jr. was known for bringing people together with all different types of backgrounds.
Yes, he was. I have some ways to celebrate Martin Luther King Day during COVID.
Hey Panthers, celebrating Martin Luther King Day during a pandemic can be quite tricky, but Mr. King once said, everybody can serve no matter what walk of life you're in. Anybody who has a heart to serve can be of service. So how can we be of service during a pandemic? Well, here's a few ideas.
Do you have a gently worn coat that you're ready to get rid of? We'll donate it. One Warm's coat mission is to provide free coats to people in need. Eddie Bauer is accepting gently worn coats. Scan the QR code for more information.
Maybe you love all your coats. Mr. King once said, if I cannot do great things, I could do small things in a great way. Mr. King, of course, did both in actions great and small. He helped to change the course of society. He is an inspiration to all of us. Why not write a letter of appreciation to an essential worker and thank them for all the hard work during the pandemic? Little things can go a long way. Your little letter of appreciation could be one's motivation to keep going.
As Dr. King once said, life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? Today, Americans across our country are answering that question through their actions. They're cleaning up parks, visiting hospitals, working at food banks, and reading to children. They're doing their part to honor Dr. King by heeding his call to serve. To everyone out there volunteering today, thank you.
Being an active member in our community is important. Anything from big to small makes a huge difference. We can all come together and make a change.
Well, that's going to do it for today's episode. Remember, MLK Day of Service is Monday, so let's try to make a difference in our community. Be sure to remind your teachers to tune in to Panther TV every Tuesday and Thursday.
And for our KBA fam, don't forget to check Canvas and follow us on Twitter and Instagram at PHS Panther TV. And cheerleaders, good luck today competing in the UIL. Bye, Panthers.
Bye.